Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about ethanol and octane. And this is a really common question because a lot of us know why we like to use ethanol, but we're also pretty new to it, and it's kind of hard to make a relationship when it's so different from pump gas. So I'm going to give you guys the information that I have, and hopefully this helps explain a little bit on what you need to do to get the most out of your setup. So ethanol is really nice. It's something that's becoming more readily available to a lot of us. But the best part of it is it has a really high octane rating. So it's basically like using race gas when you put it in your car, but it's much cheaper and much easier to access compared to, you know, ordering drums from a supplier. So this is something that a lot of people are starting to use now. Most of you guys see people running E30, E50, etc., maybe even full E85, but it's so different from pump gas, it's kind of hard to understand how that relationship works. So the way pump gas is rated in octane is basically its resistance to knock. If you have a higher resistance to knock, you can push the car harder without potentially damaging something. So most pump gases are basically processed differently in order to get different octane ratings, and that's where you see everything from regular to premium at your local gas station. Ethanol is a form of alcohol, and because of that, it has an extremely high resistance to knock. So when you actually test ethanol, a lot of the sources I've read put it at around 112 or 113 octane, which is, again, extremely high, much higher than what you'd regularly get from pump gas. Now, because it is an alcohol, there are a lot of restrictions and requirements around it. That's why they blend it with something else in order to prevent it from being just E100. The highest I've actually seen is E98, but most people get just E85 from the tank, which basically means it's 85% ethanol and 15% pump gas. This typically is rated around 108 octane. So when you mix it with fuel, it can slightly affect how the actual final octane comes into play. Especially if you have E85 that isn't actually 85% ethanol, that can affect the octane rating. And then if you're mixing it with 93 octane from one gas station, it might not perform as well as 93 octane from another gas station. So that final octane will vary, but on E30, a lot of times it ends up being rated around 98 octane. Now keep in mind, this isn't always going to be perfect math. When you're measuring octane, it's something that's not just calculated, but something that's measured. So you actually need to do a performance test to show that the fuel that you're using meets the octane requirements. That's why you'll see a lot of different ways for octane to be reached when it gets to your gas pump. You might see at your local gas station that you have 93 octane premium gas that's up to 10 or maybe even 15% ethanol. Even though it's E10 or E15, that doesn't mean that it's a higher rating than 93 octane with zero ethanol in it. If anything, I typically see better performance by mixing E85 with pump gas that has no ethanol in it at all. Because a lot of times when they have ethanol added to it, it allows them to mix it with a lower octane fuel, and that little bit of ethanol brings the total octane up to the actual rating on your pump. Also, a lot of people ask me, you know, does it matter if I mix it with 91 or 93? Or if you're in Europe, does it matter if you mix it with 95 or 98 RON? And it does make a difference. It just kind of depends on what you have available to you. At the end of the day, I don't rely on octane being my main target. I'm not trying to calculate it because, like I said, it's not something that is really a perfect science for you just to blend the fuels together and expect it to hit a certain octane. Really, your best bet is to run logs and make sure that it's performing the way that it should. When you're running an off-the-shelf map, it's designed by somebody that could have been running anything. They could have been running like E85R race ethanol gas with perfect 102 RON, like zero ethanol pump gas. You don't really know. And it's up to you to basically do your own due diligence, make sure you're getting your mix right, and run some logs to see how it's performing. If you're getting timing pull, start adding 1-2% of ethanol to your gas tank to see if it improves the performance. If you start getting fuel pressure dips, then reduce your ethanol content because now you've put too much. Usually after doing that, you're able to find a happy medium. I know on most of the E30 off-the-shelf maps when I ran them, I usually targeted around E32 on the stock pump maps and around E35 on the high-pressure fuel pump maps. And that was something that I was able to run safely, get good timing, no fuel pressure dips, and the car really liked it. But if you can't find that perfect blend, maybe you have, you know, poor quality pump fuel, or your E85 is really low ethanol content, so you're not really able to get the same performance out of your car on an off-the-shelf map, that's when it's time to go ahead and get a custom tune if you do plan on running ethanol. So these are just my recommendations based on my experience and my research. Again, you can do your own research as well. You'll see a lot of different octane ratings that people calculate for ethanol and E85. So again, it's really not something that I would try to target. Your main goal should be to get your mix right so that your fuel system likes it, and then adjust accordingly based on how your timing looks in your logs. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do